Okay, guys, I'm back. I got second part of the question sent to me from Kyle through my email, which feel free to email me a question. It's respiratorycoach@gmail.com. If you're sitting here and you're thinking, I need a clarification on this, but I don't want to put it in the comments, you'd be surprised how many people post a comment and then they delete it. And I guess they think it's a stupid comment. I'm not really sure, or a stupid question. I'm not really sure why. But what's crazy is I get a notification, so I see the question, but I have no place to go back and reply to the question when I go to reply to it. So if you ever want to send me a question and you want to ask it in a discreet way, feel free to send me an email. I'll be glad to answer it to you, just like I am Kyle right now. So the previous video was over making ventilation changes. We need to get our CO2 either up or down, and we're going to change respiratory rate or tidal volume, or maybe both of them, which we'll use the minute ventilation formula to use for that. Okay. Well, this one is more of oxygenation. It's not more of, it is an oxygenation problem. So we look at our blood gas over here. We got CO2 of 40 and a normal bicarb giving us a normal pH, no ventilation problem. Do we have an oxygenation problem? Absolutely. We're sitting at moderate level of hypoxemia right now. And then we're on VCAC. I didn't put the tidal volume and respiratory rate up here because we're just talking oxygenation. So all we really need to know right now is 40% and a PEEP of 12. Okay. Now what you have to do is, how do I know what FiO2 to put this patient on? You're going to increase it to 50. And so let's increase it to 50 and get a blood gas in an hour and then see where our PO2 is. No, that's a waste of time. You can know exactly where you need to put this FiO2 to get the PaO2 that you desire. Okay. This is the formula. It looks much like the ventilation formulas, except there's a slight difference. Okay. Your new FiO2 can be calculated by multiplying your known FiO2 by your desired O2 and divide it by your known PaO2. Now, what's frustrating to me about this, and this is why I don't even use this formula, I'm going to show you a trick here, okay? The desired on the ventilation formulas was on the bottom, so it was known times known divided by desired. Well, here, it's desired by known divided by known, which screws everything up because I learned all the other ones, and now you throw a wrench in it, right? Well, let me show you another way to do this, okay? But we'll work this problem first, okay? And then I'm going to show you what I consider to be a shortcut, okay? So if we plug our numbers in here, we're going to get a new FiO2. So I'm just going to say new FiO2. I got much more room on this one because I don't have the three formulas taking up all the board, right? Desired O2, well, right now we're at 50. So let's just go ahead and plug in our known PaO2. That's 50, okay? Not negative 50. We know our FiO2, that's 40. You're going to use that in FiO2 form, which is with a decimal, okay? And you're going to multiply that by your desired PaO2. So let's just say we want to get this patient up to 80, okay? No reason for them to be sitting mildly hypoxemic. Let's just get them back up to 80 and be done with it, right? So we do this math, and we get something like this. We get 80 times 0.4 equals 32, and we divide that by 50. And our answer here is our new FiO2 should be at 64%. If you increase this patient's FiO2 from 40 to 64%, which probably not even possible on most events, but put it to 65, okay, then you're going to get a PaO2 of 80, roughly, okay? Assuming you change nothing else, okay? Now you start changing other stuff, then you're going to mess up this relationship on the diffusion of these gases, and this may be better or worse, depending on what you do, okay? But for the most part, nothing else changes. Increasing FiO2 to 64% from 40 will increase our PaO2 from 50 to 80. That makes sense, right? If you increase FiO2, in theory, you should increase PaO2, right? Okay, so that's how you do the formula. Pretty simple, right? But what if we could make it easier? Okay, what if we talked about a formula that you should already know the number to, and that's your PF ratio? Okay, what if you already knew this number? And let me show you how easy this is, okay? If you know that your PF ratio, P stands for PaO2, F stands for FiO2. If you already know that, then you can plug these numbers in. Your PaO2 is 50, okay? Your FiO2 is 0.4. Okay, this gives us a PF ratio of, y'all doing it with me? 50 divided by 0.4. We have a PF ratio of 125. Okay, that's our PF ratio. So I'm gonna erase this so I don't confuse anybody. Now, if we know that our PF ratio is 125, then hold on a second, let me do it like this. What if we change nothing else, then our PF ratio should approximately stay the same. So what if we just plugged in numbers here? What if we said, you know what, we want our PaO2 to go up to 80. What would I have to do? What would I have to change my FiO2 to? Well, multiply both sides by F. That takes that out. Multiplies this. That makes this 125 times F. Now multiply 80 by 125. And we get 80 divided by 125 equals 80 divided by 125 equals, you guessed it, 0.64. So you just use your PF ratio. Use it and then plug the numbers in. Let me show you another way to do this. Remember I talked about in another video, you wanna really impress somebody, right? You wanna tell them what the P little AO2 is gonna be before you draw the blood gas. If we know our PF ratio is 125, okay, and let's say we came in and we said, hey, the doc said, just turn them up to 50. Just put them on 50. Then leave the P as your X and plug in 50 down here. Now I'll just multiply both sides by 0.5, right? That'll take care of that. You do 125 divided by 0.5. Nope, multiply by both sides. 125, so you're going to multiply this times 0.5. Times 0.5, and guess what? Your PaO2, when we went from 40 to 50, is now going to be approximately 62.5. Guess what, Doc? It's not high enough, is it? It's not where we want it. But we need it higher than that. We want it up to 80. Just as an example, and maybe you do want 60, and that's fine. But what I'm trying to say is, if you know where you're trying to get, and you can use this technique to know that let's not waste the blood gas telling us that our PaO2 is still mildly hypoxemic. Let's just go ahead and fix it. Then utilize these tools. I'm telling you guys, minute ventilation on the ventilation side of things, being able to quickly be able to critically think and assess and manipulate those numbers is damn near. This is damn near on the same level with it, understanding PF ratio. Because I guarantee you, when you graduate from whatever program you're in and you get out there and start working as a licensed respiratory therapist, I promise you this will be one of the first formulas you do not remember. Okay? Understanding what the PF ratio tells you and how you can manipulate it to use the same thing and achieve the same thing as this is an immense tool, in my opinion. Okay, now I will tell you this, if you're a math whiz and you like the way math works, then what you'll find is if you reorganize this formula, then what you see is you basically have PF ratio equals PF ratio, and we just had to move desired over to get it off the bottom. That's really all that it is. So we had to. It's the same thing. It's just a lot more words and a lot more busyness to it, to me, than just operating with the PF ratio. So if you like that, use it. If you don't remember this formula, do whatever you want to do. If you like this video, be sure and like it. Comment below if you need anything clarified. If you haven't subscribed already, please hit that button right there. You guys have a great day.